हेलो फ्रेंड, माय नेम इज श्याम राठौर एंड टुडे वी विल अंडरस्टैंड मीनिंग ऑफ द ग्लोबलाइजेशन। ग्लोबलाइजेशन फर्स्ट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज ग्लोबलाइजेशन। ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज दैट अराउंड द ग्लोब पीपल ऑफ द ग्लोब शेयर द नॉलेज एंड टेक्नोलॉजीज गुड्स एंड सर्विसेस एंड कैपिटल्स वन नेशन टू अनदर एंड ऑल वर्ल्ड इज इंटीग्रेटेड इन द प्रोसेस टू डेवलप द इकोनॉमीज इज कॉल्ड द ग्लोबलाइजेशन। सो नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर। इकोनॉमी ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज हिस्टोरिकल प्रोसेस द रिजल्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन innovations and technology progress. Okay, it's a result of innovations and technology progress. It referred to increase integrations of economy around the world. Okay, the economy around the world is integrated by sharing the knowledge, technologies, capitals to cross border is the form of globalization, particularly through the movement of goods, service and capital across the border. The term of sometime also refer to movement of people like labor and knowledge, technology across the international border. This is also the part of globalization, like sharing the peoples and knowledge, technology. These are also border, cultural, political and environmental dimension of globalization. According to International Monetary Fund, globalization means to growing economy, interdependence of the country worldwide through the increasing volume and variety of cross-border transaction in goods and services and of international capital flow, and also through the more rapid and widespread diffusion of technology. Okay, this is the S according to IMF, meaning the growing economy is interdependence of the country worldwide, sharing knowledge, technologies, okay, and increasing the volume and variety of cross-border transactions of goods and services. This, in this case, increase the volumes and variety of the transactions, goods and services, inflow and outflow, okay, is the also part of globalization. Okay, if you go to next, globalization refers to the process of increasing economic integration and growing economic interdependence between the nations. This is the process of increasing economic integrations, okay, and growing economic interdependence between the nations. It means integrations of different economy of the world into one global economy, thereby reducing the economic gap between the different country. Okay, just like how we can reduce the economic gap between the countries by using globalization, sharing the knowledge and technologies and providing the employment of their countries, the growth of economy depend on the knowledge and technology of and resources of their country. So it is very important to globalize the world to become a one strong economy. Okay, this is achieving by removing the restrictions on the movement of goods and services, capital, labor, technology. By removing restrictions on the movement of goods, services and capital, labor, technology between the nations, ओके सो हाउ कैन इट बिकम अ ग्लोबलाइजेशन इंटरनेशनल मार्केट. वी नीड टू रिमूव द ऑल रिस्ट्रिक्शंस जस्ट लाइक ए गुड कैन बी ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन कंट्री टू अनदर विदाउट एनी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस. सर्विस कैन बी ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन कंट्री टू अनदर विदाउट एनी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस जस्ट लाइक कैपिटल लेबर टेक्नोलॉजीज ऑल द थिंग्स कैन बी ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन कंट्री टू अनदर विदाउट एनी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस. नाउ ग्लोबलाइजेशन लीड टू एन इंक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ इंट्रैक्शंस एंड इंटरडिपेंडेंस अमंग द डिफरेंट कंट्री. ओके इट्स लीड ग्लोबलाइजेशन लीड टू इंक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ इंट्रैक्शंस बिटवीन द पीपल एंड कंट्रीज पीपल एंड द सोर्सेस. ओके हाउ इंटरडिपेंडेंस अमंग द कंट्रीज डिफरेंट कंट्रीज जस्ट लाइक सम कंट्रीज हैव नॉट अवेलेबल resources to develop and improve their economy. In that case, globalization will help. Okay, by sharing the goods and services and capital across the border. There is a flow of goods, services and technology management practice and culture across the national boundaries. From a country's viewpoint, globalization means integrations of domestic economy of the country with the world economy. This is very important line, you can understand. By country viewpoint, that the globalization mean is integration of the domestic economy of the country with the world economy. Just like whatever the resources available in their countries share with the world is also a globalization. In brief, the globalization implies being able to manufacture in the most cost effective way possible where in the world. Being able to produce able to procure raw materials and management resources from the cheapest resources anywhere in the world and having entire world in one as a one market. The globalization corporate today conduct their operations worldwide as if the entire world were a single entity. Globalization also imply the emergence of world where innovation can arise anywhere in the world. We need to understand here the resources on the globe available, but utilization of that resources is very important. So to search the appropriate requirement place and share these resources to that countries is very important part of the globalization. Just like understand the comparative advantage of the theory of economics in which we can understand the goods and resources available at the point of any corner of the world need to be shared with the world to become a globalization, to become a entire world as a one market. Because that the climate and culture is not available to produce the resources as dependency on produce where it's available. Okay, so this is very important. If you go to next, the main feature of the globalizations are mentioned here. First, reduction of trade barriers so as to ensure flow of goods and services across the nation frontier. globalization's feature is that the restrictions cross border will be reduces for movement of the goods and services rapidly. So this is the first feature to reduce the trade barrier. If you go to next, creation of the environment in which flow of capital can take place among nations. It's create the such environment where goods and capital can freely flow from one nation to another. This is the second feature of the globalization. If you go to third, creation and the environment in which permit to flow of technology between the nations. Globalization create the environment in which free flow of technology between the nations. If you go to next, creation of the environment in which free movement of the labor can take place in the different country of the world. Okay, it's create such environment in which the labors can be transferred from one nation to another. Next, creation of the global mechanism for the settlement of economics dispute between the various countries. It's create the mechanisms in such way to reduce and solve and the settlement of the economic dispute between the nations, like one country's export good to another and he receive goods in not right way. In that case, dispute arised. So in that case, globalization will help in such way that the settlement of the economic dispute will be solved easily. So guys, today we have understand main feature of the globalizations and the what meanings of the globalizations. In new video, we will get new knowledge. So please be with me in this video. Thank you for watching this video.